This video is about the mechanism of metal cutting. Consider the turning operation. Like any metal cutting process, there is a workpiece shown in orange. This is the tool which removes the unwanted material to give the finished surface. In an exaggerated view, we can see the cutting zone. This is the primary cutting edge of the tool, which separates the unwanted material from the workpiece. This material, called chip, then flows over the rake face shown in blue. If we view the cutting zone perpendicular to the cutting edge becomes a single point, and the familiar image of metal cutting shows up. This is the uncut chip, and this is the chip after being cut. It is generally found that the thickness of the chip is greater than that of the uncut chip. According to Ernst Merchant, the material fails by plastic deformation followed by shearing along this plane. The mechanism of chip formation can be shown by Pispanen's card analogy. Assume this is a bunch of playing cards. As the tool advances, the cards will slide against each other here and move upwards along the tool's rake face. As a result, the thickness changes from here to here. This happens during metal cutting as well. So this zone is called the primary shearing zone, which generates the maximum heat. There is also some rubbing of the tool with the chip and the workpiece. These zones are called secondary and tertiary shearing zones respectively. In the next video, we'll talk about the various cutting forces. Keep watching this space for more videos like this.